Hey Flob, and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to be going over the modding and downgrade process for Beat Saber version 125.1. And we're also going to cover how to get your high scores backed up and restored. Let's get into it. Before we start modding, I always like to take a look at the Quest board to see what's the most current version that has mods available for and what mods are available for that version. Go ahead and either type in questmodding.com into your search browser or click the link below. I'm going to go ahead and put links for every website that I visit in today's video in the description below so you can find all the links there. For some reason, the most up-to-date on the notice board says that 124.0 is the latest version. That's not correct. If you click on released mods, we even see that we're up to 125.1, so I'm not sure why it says that. But we'll just go ahead and ignore that for now. They probably just haven't updated it yet. So in here, we're gonna see all of the mods that are available for version 125.1. Unfortunately, cosmetics isn't available for 125.1 yet. I did not see it in the list. We still have to downgrade to version 124 to get that, which you can do by using this video. Just you'll have to go to a different version instead of 125.1. So you kind of gotta weigh out and decide, you know, do I want custom sabers for my modding, or am I looking for, you know, other mods like Trick Saber or something else that's available in this version? And that'll just be whatever you decide by looking at which mods are available. So now that we've decided on our version, let's get started and click the developer link that I put in the description below. You can either type it in or click the link, your choice. Either way, we're gonna need to log in, and then you should be met with this page. Now we're gonna go ahead and click the drop down right here and hit create. And then you go ahead and type in whatever organization name you wanna have. Make sure that you read everything before you just start clicking agree. I've already read it, but make sure you do your part. Again, understand what it is that you're agreeing to and hit submit. Next, grab your phone or device, whatever has your Oculus app on it, and open up your app. Make sure that your headset is turned on as well so that it shows connected. Then you're gonna click on menu, devices, and scroll down to developer mode and enable it. Okay, the next thing we need to do is make sure that app sharing is turned off and that you have no other accounts linked. It will cause like your downloads, like your APK and your modding files to just not work. I think it's because it's trying to share the file with the other account that you have linked. So go into your headset and we're gonna disable it. All right, so we're gonna click on settings and then accounts, and make sure that your account is the only one listed and that app sharing is turned off, just like mine is. Okay, now that that's out of the way, we need to go to sidequestvr.com or click the link in the description below. So after clicking the link, you should be met with this page here. We're going to install the advanced installer. That's the one that I'm gonna be working with in this video. Okay, next we need to plug in our Quest to our computer. You should get a pop-up window that says allow USB debugging. We're gonna hit allow. It's gonna ask you if you want to allow the connected device to access the files. We want to allow that as well. And then it's gonna ask allow USB debugging again and hit allow. So make sure that you allow all three of the pop-up windows inside the headset. If you allowed all three pop-up windows, you should be showing that you're connected now inside SideQuest. You'll have a little green marker and it'll show your Quest 2. If for some reason you're not showing connected and you didn't get the pop-up windows inside your headset, go into your settings in your headset and then go to system, scroll down to developer, and then toggle the USB connections off and then back on again, and then replug in your headset and it should prompt you to get the pop-ups. All right, let's go ahead and grab any high scores, avatar settings, or any other settings that you have saved in your game currently. Folder in the top right that says manage files. Then we're gonna click on Android, data, beat games, beat saber, and then files. In here, we're gonna wanna save avatar. Make sure it's the avatar DAT. We're gonna hit the little floppy disk looking guy. And I'm going to put these on my desktop and I'm just gonna make a new folder. And I'm just gonna go ahead and name it Quest Files. That way I know exactly what it is. And we're gonna save that one. And then we need player data, and then the settings CFG. Okay, now we need to download the APK file for Beat Saber version 125.1. Okay, head over to the MetaQuest website or click the link in the description below for oculus.com/experiences/quest and make sure that you are logged into your account that you own Beat Saber on. Once you're showing logged in, go back over to the questmodding.com and go to how to downgrade. This is going to give you version 125.1, which is the version I'm downgrading to. If you were looking for another version, I'm gonna show you how to get that here in just a minute, but for this one, we're just gonna download Beat Saber 125.1. Okay, so to get any of the other versions of Beat Saber, you're gonna obviously still have to be logged in, but then you're gonna go to the Oculus DB website, which I put a link in the description below. Right here in the search, you're gonna put Beat Saber. And then we're gonna click on details right here. And then if you're on versions, which it should automatically be, you'll get all of the different versions and you can choose whichever one you want. And you'll just obviously hit download. Okay, head back over to SideQuest and make sure you're still showing connected in the top left. And then in the search bar, we're gonna type in BMBF. And then we are going to click on download app. We'll see that it's installing in the bottom right, and we'll just wait for it to finish. All right, it says success. Now let's click on the little folder with the arrow that says install APK file. And we're gonna go to our downloads and install the Beat Saber APK. Now back into the headset, let's make sure that our APK file installed correctly. So we're gonna launch Beat Saber and it should say update available because we just downgraded. We're gonna hit update later. You're gonna have to hit this every time because it's gonna want you to update. But if you update, you're not gonna be on the right version. Now to confirm you're on the right version, click solo and then look down at your feet and make sure it says 1251 or whatever version your target was. After that, go ahead and pick any song and just let yourself fail really quickly. And then go ahead and close out of Beat Saber. Now we're gonna click on apps, and then all in the top right corner and all the way down to unknown resources, you may have to scroll, and we're gonna launch BMBF. So for some reason, my little pop-up went away, but I just clicked on the white screen and it allowed me to hit allow. If yours doesn't come back up, just exit out and relaunch BMBF. Okay, and now here's the setup. So I recommend reading everything so you kind of understand how the modding process works, but it says your version of Beat Saber 125.1, perfect, that's the one we're on, is supported. Let's get started. We're gonna uninstall Beat Saber. Pretty much we're just gonna follow along the prompts here. All right, now we're gonna install modded Beat Saber. Okay, so we're gonna have to go into settings and allow from the source and then hit back. And then restart the install. Okay, if you get this pop-up that says package installer isn't responding, just hit wait. If you hit close, you'll have to restart. Sometimes it just brings you back to the last step, but you can just go ahead and close out of this now and reopen it. So you're gonna get this restore app pop-up. Don't ever restore it, just hit close. If you restore it, you're gonna go back to your unmodded version of Beat Saber. So only hit that button if you want to restore it. And then if you get this restore after upgrade within BMBF, you can go ahead and do this. This is just your playlist. Since I've modded before, I had some songs and it's just gonna reinstall those songs for me. Okay, so now we're on a modded version. This is blinking red. You always wanna sync when this is on. It means that there are songs or mods or something that needs to be updated. Okay, now that our core mods are installed, we do have custom songs, but let's go ahead and get some other mods. Back over to the Quest board, go to released mods, choose the version that you're getting mods for, and then simply click download on any of the mods you want to download. Now back in the headset, launch BMBF again, then go to the tools page, and right here in the top corner, you're gonna see accessible via browser at, and then all of this HTTP, and all these numbers here, you need to type it exactly as it is from the H to the slash here into your browser. When you're typing it into your browser, you need to make sure that BMBF is still open and on that tools page and not idling. So I keep my headset on my forehead so that way it stays awake, but it does need to be open, and your headset and your PC need to be on the same local network. If you don't follow all those steps, the page will not load. So if you're having issues, that's most likely why. Okay, if you followed all the steps properly, you should be met with the upload files page, and you'll be showing connected down here in green. If this connection goes out, make sure your headset isn't idling. So now you can click in the center here, and we're gonna upload our mods one by one, and we'll see them queue in the bottom. If you don't see them queuing, then you're not showing connected. See how this just went out and went orange and red? My headset fell asleep, and I put it on my face again, and it's back to green. I don't know why it has to be active, but it does. And then we're gonna go ahead and sync now that we've installed all the mods we want. Make sure that you're showing success on your mods as they're going, so you know that they've synced. Okay, now let's launch Beat Saber and see if our mods are there. Again, remember, update later. If you update or restore, you're gonna have to remod. All right, we've got our notice board and our mods. Now, to search for your custom songs in-game, look over to the left under mods and go to more songs. And then up here in the search bar, you can type in either an artist or like a song name, and then you'll find options. Okay, let's check out a wall map. Okay, the last thing we need to do is check if our avatar settings are still there. Mine somehow were still here. So check if yours are, like your avatar settings or high scores. If they're not, I will show you now how to load those in. I don't know if Sidequest just like transfers those files automatically now. We used to have to do them manually, or if mine's just being weird. But if your settings are there, your high scores and your avatar settings, you don't need to do this. But if they're not there, I'll show you how to put them in. So inside of SideQuest, we're gonna go to Manage Files, Android, Data, Beat Games, Files. And then once in here, you'll click the plus sign to add a file. And then you'll go to Upload File to this folder, and then navigate to where you saved your quest files from earlier. And you can just select them and then open them in there. And that's it. All your save files should be done once they show success. Well, that wraps up our tutorial today. If the video was helpful, give it a thumbs up and turn on notifications for more videos like this in the future. If you need any help troubleshooting, feel free to shoot me a comment in the comment section, and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Also, don't forget to check the pinned comment, because I like to keep links up to date and any troubleshooting or other issues that might be relevant. Thanks again for watching.